Today I will be going over the best barber kit for beginners and experienced barbers. So if you're just starting or you have a slight bit of interest in the barber world, this is the ultimate guide for you to follow. Now everything in this video that I'm about to mention, I personally use on the daily and I believe these are the best products any barber can get. Now the first product I have for you guys today is the main machine itself, and that is our clipper. But not only do I run with one all the time, I do go ahead and use something like a Wall Senior to debulk, and then I come in with my Babyliss FX to detail and do the other work around it. Now I personally think this is the best duo when it comes to fading, but if I had to choose one, I would go with the FX, mainly because it's just an all-around clipper, and this is just for like maybe debulking or having like less time on a haircut and you want to speed through it, then I would go with the Senior. But I personally would get the FX if you're barely starting off, or an experienced barber, I would go more for a Senior. You decide. It all comes down to personal preference. If you're a beginner, you can't go wrong with any of these two. Now, to give you guys a quick little comparison, I'm gonna start off by saying you can stand this one up and you can't really do it with the Senior. On the Babyliss FX, there is little notches on the lever so you can know where you're at. If you're either lever closed, lever open, halfway, it will make some kind of sound that actually helps you out when you're fading. On top of that, this is a full metal housing and you could actually customize these to whatever colorway you want. So that's a pretty cool thing that Babyliss actually offers. Now on the Senior side, we do have half of it being plastic and then the rest metal. The only thing I'll say about this one, it doesn't have like notches. So you're gonna be kind of confused if you're a beginner. You're gonna be having to play a guessing game. If you're more experienced, then you should be able to know, or you've dealt with like a magic clip or something like that, you are gonna be able to know how this works. But most of the time, if you're a beginner, I would go with the notches itself. Not saying this is a beginner clipper, not saying that, it's just that it will help you a little bit more when it comes to knowing the lever and the guards. I do get a lot of questions on why I use both, and that's because I use this one to debulk and this one to detail. Now the next product I have in hand is our trimmer. And I know what you're thinking, yes, it does indeed match our Babyliss clipper that I just mentioned. Now, honestly speaking, this is the best trimmer you could possibly get. I do not care what anybody says. You can debulk, you can line up, you can do beards, you can do anything. It's a full metal housing. I've dropped this so many times, not this one in specific, I have other ones that I use on a daily basis, but I've dropped this so many times and it just doesn't break. Maybe every like year or so you'll need to replace the blade, but man, they just stay hitting all the time and you could do anything you could possibly want a trimmer to do. Until they make a better trimmer, this is the best I could possibly find in the market right now, and I truly mean that. Anyways, going on to the next machine, we have our shaver. And when it comes to shavers, really, they all do the same thing. The only thing about this one is that it's fully customizable to your trimmers and clippers, fully metal as well, so you could toss this in your bag without having a problem. The only thing about shavers, and this is with any other shaver, it's not just the Babyliss one, you're gonna have to replace the tip on them every now and then. But yep, I 100% believe in this product. I'm all for it. Self-care or client use, it doesn't matter. This is the shaver that you should go with. 100%. Now the next product I have, I do use on the daily. I use it in the morning for myself. I use it every single day, multiple times a day for clients, for my personal use. And that is a Dyson blow dryer. It doesn't have to be a Dyson blow dryer, but I'm a little extra like that. I personally love this one right here. If I'm generally speaking, this is the best blow dryer I've ever had to use in my entire life. Not only because it looks cool, but the functionality of it is just crazy. Like, this is how it looks. I told you guys it looks cool right here. Check that out. The reason I love this so much is because it has like three different heat settings and three different power settings. So you could mess with the power, you can mess with the heat settings, and it could do it all. It's got a long wire, very thick one too, so you'll never have a problem with like it being cut. Or the only thing you will have to be having a problem with if someone like passes by and trips on it, I guess, or something like that. Now, I know I mentioned it has so many functionalities and stuff like that. There is a reason why this thing is priced at like 400 and something, and that's because it comes with not only the best technology you could get on a blow dryer, but check these tips out. Like, this is insane. If you're a hairstylist maybe, or you work on longer hair, you could use this one right here. You have some for your comb overs. I'm not gonna lie, I don't know what this does. I'm not lying. What does this do? Like, the way you clamp things is so easy. Check this out. It's magnetic, so you can literally just like cut them off and then boom, you could twist them. You could do anything with this freaking Dyson blow dryer. If you want to defuse it right here, boom, diffuse. It does literally everything you want a blow dryer to do. If you want it to be in this direction, that direction, it does everything. Again, I'm not saying to buy this specific blow dryer, but if you do have the money for it, by all means, this is the best blow dryer I've ever used. I actually own two now. And all I can say is I freaking love this blow dryer. But yeah, anyways, on to the next product. Now the next product I have is basically your utilities for barbers, and that is your shears and razor right here. Now to quickly touch up, I'm not crazy going with like 10 pairs of shears and stuff like that. I am not like that. The only two I use is my blending shear and my regular shear, my CSL series and my TS40s. Blending shear, regular shear, all I use on a daily basis when it comes to cutting the top or maybe something towards a parietal ridge or something like that. This is my Irving razor holder, and I absolutely love this razor holder, not only because it's fully metal and chrome and it matches my shears and stuff like that, but the thing about this one is that if you like a blade more exposed, you could go ahead and do it with this one. It has that option, and then it has the other option where you, if you like it more hidden, then you could do that as well. If you're gonna work on designs, you want more exposed blades as well as the hidden one, this does it all. The only thing about this razor holder is that it is about $100. When it comes to a razor holder, most of them are like $10 to $15, so maybe even $5. But yeah, that's something to take into consideration when you're about to buy this. Quality matters in this case. Now when it comes to razors, guys, make sure you're clean and you replace each razor for every client. That is the reason I have these right here. These are the Darko premium razors that go into that holder I was just talking about. What these are is they look like little packs of gums, but you can just slide out your razor right here, split it in half, and then you're good to go. This is actually for two clients right here. I could just put this little razor into the razor holder and you are good to go. They are very sharp, and yes, I do suggest the premium darker ones. Now, before you start any haircut, you do need your neck strips and your cape. Now, the only thing I look for in a cape is if it has these little hooks, because they're easily accessible and easy to strap on around the neck. Now, these are pretty self-explanatory, but if you don't know why barbers actually use them, it's for two different reasons. Now, the first one is to prevent infection spread, and the second one is to actually keep the hair away from the body itself. They will act like another layer on top of the cape, that way no hair goes into the clothes or anything like that. Now, speaking of hair being all over the place, you do need a duster, and this is not just any duster, this is the Denman duster. I will link it down below. I personally have never seen anybody use it but me, but I love it because it fits your palm just like so right here. Check this out. It perfectly fits it right here, and you can just brush all day and just keep cutting. It's honestly the best duster there is out there. I know a lot of people use those powder dusters and all that. I just love this one. The bristles are perfectly soft, and it's just good for the client and yourself. Now, the next product is my very own product, and I know you need these. These are MB Translucent Premium Guards. The ability to have like maybe red on red like so, it's just freaking cool. So I know Babbel has thought about their customization, but why not add on to it? Because there is always gonna be a time where you have a guard on that clipper. Honestly speaking, every barber, every hairstylist will need guards in order to complete a haircut. And these are the way to go. This is the multicolor version, but if you want a single color, they are available using this card right here, linked right there. And go ahead and get yourself a pair, because every single barber needs these. These products I have in hand are combs, and these are specific combs for different uses, but this one is obviously a styling comb right here. This is a fade comb. And then we have your regular barber combs. These are a huge help when it comes to getting that hard part or just sectioning at the beginning of the haircut, laying down the haircut. You always need these. These are a must. Now, these right here are barber brushes. I doubt you have ever seen translucent barber brushes, and that's because they are my very own barber brushes. This is another must when cutting hair. You always wanna have your clipper and your barber brush in order to lay all the hair down, get all the hair off, so you can visibly see everything that's going on. This is a huge must, and you must have it in your lineup. So yeah, guys, make sure to pick this up. The card will be linked up there, and you can pick them up in like a single or a 5-pack, whatever you want. All right, guys, so now we have our shave gel and aftershave. Now, when it comes to shaving gel and aftershave, I absolutely love this product right here because it smells so damn good. Seriously, every client tells me, yo, what is that? Yo, that smells so good. There's some guys that come in with the girls and they're like, oh my God, it smells so good. What is that? Like, guys, and I'm not kidding. The scent is super fucking good. I don't know what it is. I don't know if you guys know what Abercrombie & Fitch is, but if you've ever walked into a store, it kind of smells like that. So yeah, anyways, next product. All right, now hair clips. You guys know these are super important when I start up a fade, because I tell you to do your first parting and then clip them with these themselves. So yes, pick these up ASAP. Guys, and speaking of those hair clips, there's also hair grips, and these are perfect for like man buns and whatnot. So yeah, keep that in mind. gloves. This is something else you should also use as a barber. Let me open this up. These are black vinyl gloves and they're pretty good. I rather have nitrile, but they just weren't available at my nearest supply store. But hey, these will work. They're a little too big on me actually, but yep. Anyways, this is the 100 pack in the large vinyl. I rather have nitrile gloves, the non-powdered version, and that's that. Make sure you get yourself some gloves. Next up, you need a spray bottle. You must need this. This one's actually an automatic one. I know you've probably seen these. These are more common now, but they just, if you keep pressing this, it will keep bursting out. Water, this is actually a small one. I like the small ones only because I feel like if I have a really big one, it's just dangling all over the place. I just like the small ones personally. I don't know what it is. Hey, fuck it. Now that we've mentioned all of that, it's time for the styling section. Remember to always style before the client leaves. I like to do it with these volumizing powders right here. Then I have statement clay right here. And then I have the shining clay right here. I just like having a shine paste and a dry clay. On top of that, I like mixing it up with these volumizing powders. So yeah, that's that. Now let's say you've given the best haircut you've ever given anybody. You styled them, you need one more thing. And if you've already guessed it, yes, you do need hairspray. I personally like this hairspray. It's at Walmart. It's very, very easy to go get real quick. I believe it's like $5 and yeah, it's super easy. It'll hold up your hair all day. And it's also personally what I use on the daily basis. Finally, what a lot of people miss out on when choosing out a barber kit is disinfectants and blade care. Now, when it comes to maintenance, you're gonna need your clip oil for like day-to-day basis. And then your all-in-one clipper spray right here, because you will need to disinfect after every client and stuff like that. On top of that, you will need a blade wash. This one's very, very oily and it's just spilling everywhere because I've used it before. And generally speaking, I only use this about like every couple months because I do replace my blades more often than not. But if you don't feel like replacing and just oiling your clippers all in one, getting all the dirt and grind out, then this is perfect for that right there. All right, now towards the end of the day, every single day, and towards the end of this video, I do need to put this out right here. Marvicide will go into a bottle, into a glass bottle, preferably, and that is somewhere you could put all the combs and the fade combs into in order to disinfect throughout the day, and then you're able to wash them at the end of the day. And then we have Ship Shape right here, and this will get literally rid of everything that you seriously use will be clean with this right here. You just dip it in there, have it for like 10 minutes, and then take them out, and they're seriously ready to go for the next week or so. You don't need to use it every single day. It would be nice to, but I think your tools will get kind of ruined because it's so strong. But anyways, now that concludes the end of the barber kit. If you do want to pick something up that I just mentioned, everything will be linked down below. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe. That's been it for me. I'm Marty Blends and I'm out. Peace.